Starting with image 43, PeopleSoft provides asset accountants and asset managers with high-performance and intuitive analytics dashboards that offer insight into accounting period and year-over-year asset data. The Asset Analytics Dashboard presents asset data as of a specific point in time. This dashboard displays visualizations for an asset management business unit, asset book, fiscal year, and accounting period. The default asset management business unit and asset book are determined by asset management user preferences, while the fiscal year and accounting period are determined by the asset book calendar and current system date. Use the asset filter to override the default dashboard filters and further refine the visualizations. Let's update the asset type to equipment to redraw the visualizations. The metrics and charts are now specific to equipment assets only. Remove the filter to return to the default display. All visualizations are in the asset book currency. The first three metric visualizations are asset count, total cost, and net book value. The charts that follow provide further detail for each of the metrics. The first chart displays the top 10 asset types that represent the total asset count. Each stacked bar displays the comparison of capitalized and non-capitalized assets. You can redraw visualizations by selecting any one of the bars and changing the filters. By selecting equipment, you can now evaluate asset cost, depreciation and amortization, and net book value in the context of the asset categories associated with equipment. Remove the filter to return to the default display. The final chart on this dashboard provides a side-by-side comparison of asset cost and net book value for each of the top 10 asset types. This quickly identifies opportunities for budget planning and further investigation. The Asset Details table completes this dashboard. It includes a link to the printable asset view, and you can export results to Excel for further analysis and reporting. The Year-over-Year Asset Analytics Dashboard provides a view of trends related to asset activity and the financial impact. The default dashboard filters include Asset Management Business Unit and Asset Book. Like the Asset Analytics Dashboard, these values default from the Asset Management User Preferences. The default time frame for this dashboard represents the prior and current fiscal years. You can override the filters and further refine the dashboard results using the asset filters. Like the Asset Analytics Dashboard, all amounts display in the book currency. The year-over-year charts identify trends and reveal unexpected anomalies. For example, the asset acquisitions chart enables you to determine if asset acquisitions align with your organization's plans. Use the depreciation and amortization chart to evaluate if these expenses meet year-over-year expectations. The year-over-year retirement gain loss chart displays any unusual spikes in asset retirement gains or losses. Analyze if the relationship between asset cost and net book value is steady from year to year using the year-over-year cost versus net book value chart. You can also monitor asset acquisition and retirement activity using side-by-side line charts to determine if there are more asset acquisitions or asset retirements at certain times of the year. A table listing asset details completes this dashboard. Asset details are organized by fiscal year and accounting period, and like the asset details table on the Asset Analytics Dashboard, you can use the links to transfer the printable asset view, and you can export results to Excel for further analysis and reporting. The Asset Management Analytics Dashboards provide asset accountants and asset managers with insight into asset counts, acquisitions, disposals, cost, and net book value. The visualizations intend to support not only financial reporting, but also budget and tax planning. For more information, go to peoplesoftinfo.com.